we had another welterweight make the news this week. Keith Thurman came out and said that he wants to regain his own old form and dominate the welterweight division again. I know with Bud in the division, you know what I'm saying? You think Bud is the number one guy, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't gonna ask you that. But do you think Keith Thurman can come back and dominate the PBC side of things and get his titles back?
Nah, hell no, nah, man. Shit, no. Nah. He can fight some of those 147 pounders over there and make it look like he's the number two guy over there. But, you know, as far as dominate the division, you know, he got a long road back. So, you know, hey, best wishes to him, you know, and let him do his thing.
But, Bo, man, let's say Keith Thurman comes back and he's the Keith Thurman before he fought Sean Porter. Everything's healthy, no lingering issues, no elbow, no hand, no none of that. You don't think Keith Thurman can possibly, you know what I'm saying, get back and give Errol Spence a run for his money?
No, I think Spence will probably stop him, man.
Damn.
I think he'll stop. If he can catch up with Keith, he'll stop him.
Stop him?
Yeah, he'll stop him. He'll stop him. But Spence, man, he gotta use his legs, man. He gotta be able to use his legs more than just one way. You know what I'm saying? Cause Keith, man, he'll dance circles around you and shit. He'll be in and out and shit. If Spence can keep up with him and have his punches precise, I think he'll stop him.
Wow, that's a big statement right there. We ain't never seen Keith stop, even when we seen him hurt. We seen him manage to get out the round. So stop him! Wow.
Yeah, but see, that's different. But that's a different fighter, and he gets a different animal in there. You know what I'm saying?
That's true.
That's way different animal. You know, hey, Spence, man, he gonna go for the kill. He going for the kill. That's just the type of fighter he is.
Speaking of Errol Spence, there's been rumors that him and Danny Garcia are supposed to fight this summer, you know what I'm saying, after everything's cleared up with this pandemic. At what level do you expect Errol Spence to come back at, and what kind of threat does Danny Garcia pose to him in that potential matchup?
It's going to be tough for a couple, you know, it's going to be a back and forth for the first couple rounds, and then Errol's probably going to walk away with the fight towards like 7, 8, 9, and 10, or maybe 8, 9, 10, and 11. He'll walk away with it. He might take the 11th round off and finish strong in the 12th round, you know. But I think it's an easy fight for Spence, you know. He got a good chin. He's strong. He's bigger than Garcia, Danny. And it's just a matter of time before he get him out of there. Or just beat him.
What do you rate Danny Garcia in the group of welterweights right now? Is he above like a Sean Porter? Is Sean Porter him on the same level, or is
no, Danny? I think he probably like sixth or fifth, five or six. Yeah, he ain't in that top epsilon no more, man.
Now, was there anything to come? I know that there was an offer sent to Danny Garcia a couple of years, well, maybe like a year and a half back. Has there been any kind of like rumblings or any kind of negotiations behind the scene with a Danny Garcia that possibly like we don't know about?
No, I don't know. We always ask him. We always have Bob Lynn or Carl send us, you know, like a little, you know, you want to fight, a little offer out. But nothing ever materialized, man. Those guys over there, what they doing is they fighting amongst each other. You know, they milking the cow, and then once the cow goes dry, and then they'll look for Plan Bs and shit. But right now they got a slew of 147 pounders over there, and for them to go out and fight one of the dangerous fighter in the game and shit, that's something that, you know, I don't think their advisors are gonna even advise them to do.